Do you ever feel like your marriage needs a little jump start? Maybe the two of you are in a rut, like two ships passing in the night. Well, today, marriage, family, and child therapist Juliana Lindney is here with tips on getting the spark back. Good to see you.
Hey, good to be back.
So the thing that we hear a lot is, I'm tired when I get home. Everybody's working. We're dead tired. You know, how do we jump start? How do we get it fresh again?
And you know, the thing is, marriage is difficult. We have to work to a certain degree, and you know, we have to pay attention to what we're doing, how we're doing it. And one way to keep it fresh is to make that date night every single week. If you can't make it every week, you have to make it at least twice a month.
People really that I know that do date night really look forward to it, and they stick to it. They don't let anything interfere. So after a, I mean, there's always something that's going to come up.
Yes, you know, there is, but that's why we have to make a commitment. We have to work at keeping our marriage fresh, and that's one way we can do it. I mean, if you miss it, then you got to make up for it the next week if you can.
And Juliana, how do we keep the spontaneity going?
You know, as Nike says, just do it.
Just do it.
It really is true. If you're waiting around for your partner to become more spontaneous, you might be waiting a long time. So I say, just kick it in, jump start it, start doing more spontaneous activities. Things like writing a love letter. It's a lost art. Write down why you fell in love with your partner. Drop it in the mail. Maybe make that dinner that you haven't made in a while, or buy that beautiful piece of lingerie for a romantic evening. You know, it goes both ways. Yeah. Men and women both need to do it.
How about an extra long text?
That would work. That would definitely work.
No, it wouldn't.
Whatever way you can find to get in there and make that difference. Yeah.
And the surprises too. I mean, you don't have to be on the same page as far as what you want to do from a spontaneity standpoint. You know, surprising each other is really a key too.
Yeah. And it's so fun. I mean, you never know what the other's going to come up with. And studies show that when we create more spontaneity, our partner reciprocates.
Yeah, yeah. You know, the goal is to find somebody that you love, get married, and be married forever. But a lot of people say, you know, the passion kind of fizzles out after I've been married so long. How do we stop that? How do we change that mindset right now?
Well, you know, the thing is, studies show that couples well into their 80s are still having active sex lives. They're still having passion that's overflowing. And the one way we can work on that is we can start to build the respect in our marriage. And what that means is paying attention to the wants, the desires, the needs of both of you. So it's a give and take. It's really a balancing act. And when you do this regularly, you'll find that the passion starts to just ignite.
Well, and if you're lucky enough, as I was, to marry your best friend, it all becomes so much easier.
Oh, that's a gift.
It really does. But you know, you talk about communication, and that's something that we always hear is the secret is communicating. But that doesn't necessarily mean talking all the time, does it? Because like my husband's very quiet. Mm-hmm. He still communicates.
Yes, well, communication really is the foundation to any marriage, and it's finding that how you connect with him that makes the difference, what makes that unique for you. But some of us go into this silent treatment, and we have to be very, very careful because that can create a lot of damage within the marriage. And so we need to find ways to express ourselves that are healthy, maybe taking that time out to collect your thoughts or getting some therapy if you need it.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, one of the things that you say is super, super important is to just play.
Oh,
what do you
yes.
mean by that?
You know, marriage may be work, but it's a lot of fun. It's creative. It is playful. And so start reminiscing about those times when you used to be fun, when you used to be silly, and get out there and do those things. If you're with the family and you're at the miniature, golf place, play. If you're at the beach, do boogie boarding or, you know, surf or do those things together, because when we play, it is a bonding, connecting experience.
I say get a ton of pets too.
Maybe
not such a good idea for some.
No, they're the best. They're the best. I couldn't live without them.
Do you still believe that people should marry, you should be the same, or do opposites attract? What's your philosophy?
You know, my philosophy is so much about opposites attracting.
Wow.
Because I think that we need sometimes a little bit of what the other has to give us that impetus to become even better. But it doesn't mean that you can't marry someone that's just like you. You know, they're all so different.
Oh my gosh, if my husband had the energy I did, we'd both go over a cliff. So it's good thing. Thank you so much.
Oh,
great information and great reminders. And for more tips and information, everyone, contact Juliana at juliana@gmail.com.